The BP Gulf of Mexico destruction, as uncovered by a truth soldier, December 25th, 2010. Here is another gift of truth to the world. So are you ready to learn and discover what has been done by British Petroleum in the resulting perpetual destruction of all life in the Gulf of Mexico and possibly far beyond? Altering of the world's weather patterns by stopping the flow of the Gulf Stream's warm waters up the Atlantic seaboard and onto Europe. Which is why you are witnessing the cooling of the Northern Hemisphere and the freezing of Europe and the continental USA. After you read this and investigate all the links I will provide to the videos, documents and internet sites, you will understand my question. So here goes. I will explain to you in plain simple language what has happened, and I will also mention other truth soldiers' enlightened theories as to why anyone could possibly do all this destruction for money. I would like to mention that I do not believe that there is any shortage of oil on this planet. What there is a shortage of easily and cheaply retrievable oil. I will tell you a short story about the Russian discovery that the core of the Earth is filled with oil and that this oil over time squeezes up into the imperfections in the Earth's crust and fills voids and hollows. The voids and hollows is where most of the Earth's oil has been retrieved from. But the oil companies have emptied most of these economical voids. There are many other huge oil reserves such as off Alaska and the Falkland Islands of South America. And yes, deep under the Gulf of Mexico. Remember when the British fought a war for that seemingly worthless piece of land? That is because there is a 1,500 miles long protrusion of land just under the surface of the water that holds huge reserves of oil. The oil companies needed to convince everyone that there is a shortage of oil so they could bring the costs to the consumers up. So that this increase in profits would provide them the funds to process the oil in places that are far from their markets. These places need huge and very costly infrastructures to process the oil and the added costs of the long distance to ship to the faraway markets. But the Russians went in a different direction. They went down. I learned of this years ago when I read an article about mercenaries that went to a new India oil well that the Russians were hired to drill for India. The mercenaries killed everyone involved, destroyed the oil rig and threatened to do the same to anyone that spoke of this well or tried to drill another one. What the Russians discovered, pioneered and perfected was extremely deep oil well drilling. The Russians long ago discovered that wells drilled 15 miles into the core of the Earth never run out of oil and that indeed the core of the Earth is made of oil. Just a note. The Russians have experienced deep well blowouts. They cap these by using nuclear detonations deep underground. These detonations literally melted and fused the Earth's crust and stopped the runaway oil wells. The other insane New World Order oil companies had never before attempted a deep well until the Gulf of Mexico disaster. So now I will tell you what happened. Why it happened, what BP has done to make the situation even worse. BP does not have the technology or know-how that the Russians developed. But BP executives were criminally greedy as usual for members of the Zionist New World Order corporations. Corporations plus corruption, so what did BP do? They took huge risks into the unknown. They, as usual, put money and profits above everything else. and they always achieved this by burying the truth and employed their mercenaries to kill any truthers anytime they felt like it. So I am about to unbury the evil truth for you as to what they did. BP contracted, hired, the most expensive and technologically advanced deep-sea oil drilling platform the world had ever built. The so-called $300 million Deepwater Horizon oil rig had a perfect safety record and the best crew in the world. BP hired Deepwater Horizon to drill a well 1 mile down below the surface of the water and then more than a mile below the surface of the ocean floor into a known huge oil reserve. BP knew and criminally did not care that they were drilling into a known tectonic fault line, known as the Mississippi Fault Line, that follows all the way up the Mississippi through North America. Further to what I explained earlier about oil from the core of the earth is the reason why there is so much oil below the Gulf of Mexico, and is because of the crevices, cracks and imperfections in the earth's crust due to the fault line. So BP drilled the first of two wells at that location. BP was doing what they had no previous experience or knowledge about. That is drilling a really deep well under the weight of 1 mile of fluid ocean. The Russians long ago knew the obvious dangers of doing this. The danger being, what would you do if you had a runaway well 1 mile below the sea surface? A depth that no human can go to. Not even in a submarine. Deepwater Horizon drilling is the most stupid and criminally insane greedy thing to do. So what happened, you might be asking yourself by now? Here is what happened, and it will shock you when you learn about the genetically created microorganisms that have been unleashed on this planet by BP into the Gulf of Mexico. So you need to know some basics about deep well drilling and how they get that oil to the surface. It is not pumped up, as no pumps on Earth could do that. Many think that the oil is under extraordinary pressure and that when the well is drilled, the oil will come gushing up to the surface under its own pressure. Well, that was not the situation under the Gulf of Mexico. That oil was not under any pressures. It just sat there. So BP knew this from many other wells they have drilled in their history. What they do is drill the well all the way down into the huge oil-filled hollow that is called an oil reserve. Until that day, they had always pumped down natural and organic bacteria-like organisms that would react and grow off of its consumption of the oil. This would then cause a reaction that would bring up the pressure to about 1500 pounds per square inch as expected and make it possible to retrieve the now pressurized oil. So now BP did not care what pressurizing a huge oil reserve at a fault line might do. BP's criminal negligence did not stop there. Keep reading, it gets much, much worse. What BP did is they unleashed a DNA genetically engineered microorganism that never existed on this planet before. Again, BP cared not what this could do to this planet if it ever got into the wild natural world and the diverse ecosystem of the Gulf of Mexico. BP only cared about money and profits. So now this newly created microorganism did the unknown. It grew and grew as it consumed the oil. This organism grew so quickly that it dangerously pressurized the oil reserve to approximately 80,000 pounds per square inch. This caused the first oil well to literally blow apart. The super high pressures went up and cracked the well casing pipe and blew through all the blowout preventers. No man-made engineering can control such high pressures. I will soon tell you more about what else these high pressures did and are still doing. So now the well drilling process had stopped. So BP ordered that the second well be drilled and the oil rig workers refused to do this as the first well blowout had destroyed all the safety systems. The oil rig workers were very concerned as to why all the safety systems had failed. I assume the oil rig workers did not know that BP had injected a genetically created organism into the well. So typical of the corporate mind. The BP executive cared about nothing but profits. So 3 days before the second well blew up the oil rig, BP executives had landed on the oil rig and they were having a very loud shouting dispute with the oil rig bosses. BP complained that the well was 6 months behind schedule and that this delay was costing BP huge losses. The rig workers did not want to continue on with all the failed and unrepaired damaged safety systems. But the oil rig workers were forced to continue and 3 days later when the rig reached the now extremely pressurized oil reserve. The super high pressures and the methane that the microorganisms were creating came tearing up the pipe and went up and blew the top off the oil rig. This happened because the scentless methane gases got sucked into all the generators that were running on board. The huge generators sped up so fast that they began to blow the electrical systems. The resulting sparks ignited the scentless methane gas and the whole oil rig burned and sank. Meanwhile, the first oil well was still leaking and now untold to the general public, there were now two oil wells leaking. Oh, it just keeps getting worse. Please read on. The first damaged well was very minor compared to what happened with the second one. So now the whole world knew something was very wrong. As usual, the criminally insane began their cover-up and disinformation program. New World Order corporate executives think the people are nothing but dumb sheeple and that they never deserve to know the truth at any time. Now I will tell you more about what the huge pressures were doing below the surface of the Earth. You can verify this by watching the videos I will provide the links to below. Videos from the unmanned submersibles showing that the Earth's crust had been cracked in every direction out to 30 miles or more. The videos clearly showed that the Earth's surface was heaving open and closed and that oil and everything else from below the Earth was now uncontrollably leaking out from the cracks. But you realize that the genetically created organisms were also being released into the ecosystem to cause unknown permanent and perpetual damages. So what does BP do when they were forced to show the world the undersea live video feeds? They showed the world their attempts to stop the very minor leak at the first well. The world was not shown the real damaged second well. As the world was watching the video feeds, the oil and everything else was spreading and destroying everything in its path in the Gulf of Mexico. You can have a look at the many photos I will provide links to and see the huge destruction and the killing of all wildlife under and above the sea. So now that the oil and damage was being viewed by people all over the world, the BP executives got really scared and decided to commit another even worse crime against this planet. Are you ready for this? It is going to shock you even more. So as Obama was now threatening all reporters will jail if they continued to report any news about the destruction of the environment, BP unleashes its army of aircrafts and boats to flood the ocean and the atmosphere with yet another genetically created organism. This was called Corexit, and it was an organism that eats all carbon-based life forms. This means anything that is alive, plants, animals, natural microorganisms, and even people. The purpose for this non-stop spraying was to hide the oil from view and to keep it and all the dead wildlife from showing up. The Corexit causes all life forms to sink to the bottom of the sea and also the oil. The Corexit is a genetically created artificial life form that will keep growing until it has consumed and killed everything. It will surely spread all over the oceans. But wait, it gets worse again. Reports have come in that Corexit gets picked up by the rains and has been discovered as far away as 3,000 miles north in Ontario, Canada. You can watch many private videos on YouTube showing the damage that the rains are doing to plants and trees. It is feared that the Corexit will find its way into all freshwater lakes and rivers, then killing all life forms along the way. So now all reporting pertaining to the Gulf disaster is banned. But all along the Gulf Coast, people and wildlife are affected. It was reported on PAC Alert Press that Obama announced to world leaders that the potential exists for millions of deaths due to the BP disaster. Just today it has been announced that the oil has been discovered. It is at least a foot deep and covers thousands of square miles under the sea. The future implications of this man-made disaster will never end. Now scientists have said that the Gulf Stream has stopped flowing north, which is why Europe has experienced what they call a new ice age, and central USA is experiencing unseen before rains and snowstorms, with never before recorded cold temperatures, and now absolutely shocking heat waves of extremely high temperatures, even in winter. Also, this added heat is causing record numbers of extremely huge and powerful multiple tornadoes in the USA. I can add this to the scary weather. I live in Nova Scotia, Canada, which is located on the east coast on the Atlantic Ocean above the USA in the Gulf of Mexico. For the past 3 months, we have been getting storm after storm, each with very heavy rainfalls and constant non-stop hurricane force winds of 100 to 130 kilometers per hour. Therefore, many scientists are saying it has the potential to start another ice age. I learned all of the above thanks to Truthers. I hope that now you understand how important it is that we all put truth back to where it belongs. At the front of all human activity, for truth is absolute and it is an action. So become an activist in the worldwide truth revolution. Do not be a coward and do not make me feel like I am the only sane person remaining on this planet. I feel that I live on a planet run by the insane. Insanity is absolutely the opposite of truth. Are you insane or do you seek the truth? The worldwide truth revolution needs you to join and become a truth soldier. When the seeds of truth are sown, the grassroots truth revolution will blossom from the enlightenment. Readers comments. Carolyn says, December 29, 2010. I live 1 hour north of the Gulf. I have lost a lot of insects that were constantly buzzing around my fruit trees. Gone since the first storm after the oil spill. Lots of them. Just not ants, wasps, and fleas. Lots of love. Thanks, Karenla. I will be here till the end. Don't wanna be around if an Armageddon hits and unleashes the weirdos. Lots of love. Comment by Mental. December 31, 2010. Corrects it is a GMO. What? Comment by Daniel J. Towsey, a truth soldier. January 1, 2011. The information about the GMOs is a well-hidden fact that will require more investigation. I know it is true, but I would rather not provide my source. I think more people should look into this and then provide their findings. If more people research this, then the source will be protected. You just need to understand that. Yes, they use live agents to react to the oil. Those agents are man-made GMO organisms. Comment by Farisi. February 1, 2011. I just added this website to my bookmarks. I like reading your posts. Thanks. My apologies. Just saw another article on the subject via Rents. I am mental. Thanks, D. Comment by Anatur. February 14, 2011. Thank you. What a great comment. I am going to add this to my post and a PDF of the post. Dear Daniel, did you read my 34th edition? If not, here it is, http://www.truedemocracy.net/hj34/index.html. I had the enormous good fortune to meet the man who had the solution to the BP oil spill. He lives here in Oxford, England, and we chatted a couple of times on the phone. BTW, BP is owned by Rothschild. What's new? He owns literally everything. God bless. Arlene. John Wynne says, there will be literally millions of victims. People need to understand. The sea and the air are not really separate bodies. There is only one atmosphere with a constant exchange between the sky and the sea and the earth. When we sink tens or hundreds of millions of barrels to the seabed, it comes back up again into the air as evaporated water which we breathe. The air goes up into the clouds and falls down again as rainwater. It is constant, this exchange of polluted water with the air and the rain. Never ending. The oil and the dispersants just keep changing form. But the pollution is always there. The air and the water of the Gulf region are not contained to that area. There is a constant exchange with all of the world's water and air over time. That much pollution cannot happen without tremendous increase in morbidity and mortality, especially in the areas within several hundred miles of the disaster and the seriously affected areas throughout the region. I wish that people would get out of there. Tracy Town from Melbourne, Victoria, Australia says, Daniel, I have just read your article on the oil spill destruction. I cried and cried, and will most likely cry some more. Thank you so much for explaining what the organisms are. I knew they were there, just didn't know what they were. Your information about the correct SIT 900 was also extremely enlightening. I knew the damage it would cause, but not to this extent. Our beautiful planet. I always felt in my heart that the criminally insane had done this for some stupid reason only known to themselves. When will people understand that they can't eat money? It is useless. You have confirmed and taught me so much, and I am ever grateful for you and your bravery. Now, on to spread the word. Peace always. Brother, keep on truthin'.